In this video, I will make a vertical press which can be used for wood and lino cut printing, embossing, pressing plant specimens, pressing recycled HDPE, flat, or even general wooden block and veneer glue ups. I did a bit of research and found a few designs I like the look of. I imagine the first press had a thick piece of metal recessed between the two pieces of ply at the top. In any case, I'm going to make my own version. The price tags of these are quite high. I'm going to use a similar method to the vertical CNC stand I tried to make in November 2015, using threaded rods with large flange nuts to create the structure. The first thing I'm going to do is cut some 12mm threaded rod for the four columns and a fifth for the pressing screw. As long as they are more or less the same size, this should be fine. I then cut the pieces for the top, bottom and plunging sections of the press, making sure to batch the cut so all the pieces were identical. In this case I made all the 400mm cuts first and the 313mm cuts afterwards. This is going to be an A4 press. I also cut some straight edges with the offcuts. I will clamp against these, which will help me pull the boards flat when gluing. I set up a stop block on the pillar drill and made the 12mm holes for the threaded rod about 30mm in from the edge.
And then you have to flip it round this way to keep it in proportion, blow any dust away.
Again, you want to complete this part of the process in one go, in case something moves and you lose alignment.
Okay, so this is going to be the bottom piece.
I glued the bottom section using the threaded rod to help hold the piece in place and then clamped that against the straight edges. If you have a nail gun, you can whack a few brads in to stop the pieces sliding around. The base isn't as flat as I'd like. I guess if I'd glued more layers of thinner sheet material, the straight edges could have pulled the surface flatter. But I'll just add some 18mm MDF between the base and the plunge plate at a later stage. I'm going to work on the plunging section of the press now. I decided to drill the guide holes of the plunge section to the same diameter some copper pipe I had. The original 12mm holes were too small and would snag. The pipe or bushing would help the section move across the threaded rod a little more easily. I used a pipe cutter to cut the copper to 36mm length and a deburring tool to clear the ends out. I then glued the two pieces together, clamped them, and while the glue was still wet, pushed the copper pieces into their openings. I now need to bed a M12 stud connector nut into the top pieces of the press. I first glued and nailed them together and then drilled a hole the same size as the narrowest piece of the connector nut. This was about 18mm. You could use a threaded rod with washers to push the nut into place, but I decided to use a lump mallet. This was a little bit silly because the nut went in at a slight angle, so I had to take this out and file two opposite surfaces to compensate for this. If this is not square, the plunger will snag on the threaded rod columns. I also cut two pieces of square ply, which will make the section the pressing screw is attached to. I was going to use an E-clip, but decided for a simpler method using what I had available. I glued and tapped one of the flanged nuts at the end of the threaded rod.
Just going to file the end down to flatten it off.
And then drilled a hole with a large 35mm forcing bit into either side of the two square pieces I had cut with a combined depth that equaled the thickness of the flange nut and two washers. This was about 6mm deep on one side and 17mm on the other. One piece also had a 12mm hole for the threaded rod.
Is that if it's in there? A little bit of wiggle room in there. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to put a bit of grease in here so this can turn and push against here, a little bit just on the top as well, so it doesn't grind the metal down if it's not perfectly flat. The next thing I need to do is drill a 12mm hole in the center of this bit of aluminium and a few holes around this, which will allow me to clamp this to the top of the press.
This is going to stop the stud connector I hammered in earlier from popping out like a hernia. It would have been a lot more elegant if I had tapped a thread on this plate and recessed it between the ply like the example from the beginning. I'm now assembling the various parts of the press using the press itself to glue the two parts of the plunging plate together. I then fix an aluminium plate to the top of the press and secure a final stud connector to use with a ratchet as the tightening handle. I squashed a little bit of sweet geranium and it's clear the press can apply a lot of pressure. I'm planning to make some woodcuts with the CNC machine I'm currently building and then use those with the press.
It smells very good as well. See the juices come out.
Anyway, I should also announce that I set up a Etsy page which I'll be using to sell digital files alongside some of my videos. So for example, if you'd like to purchase a collection of digital files for the press, you can visit my website, the link to which will be in the card in the description, and there, if you make a purchase, you will receive a collection of files including a Fusion 360 file, as well as an AutoCAD DXF and an SVG vector file, which you can use as a reference, taking measurements off, or with a CNC machine to cut your own parts. I've had some interest over time by people who have wanted plans for things I've built, and I've normally ignored them, but in my old age, I'm a little wiser and a little more patient for things like this now. I've also put the cam clamp files online, and there'll be extra things including the swan pushing stick and so on. Anyway, thanks again for watching and checking out my Etsy page. Please sacrifice a thumb to the algorithm gods if you haven't done so already, and I'll catch you at the next one.